All right, in part number five here, we're asked to verify the following identities. And so the idea here is we want to start with one of the sides of this equation and use identities to transform it into the other side. So we typically start with the more complicated of the two expressions, which you could argue is this one. There's a fraction over here, there's no fraction over here. And so that's how we'll start, with cotangent theta over cosecant theta. And my goal is to transform it into cosine of theta. All right, so the identities we have at our disposal, we have the reciprocal and quotient identities, and that seems like a good place to start, because the reciprocal and quotient identities will let us turn this expression back into terms involving cosine and sine. So, I know the cotangent of theta is the same as the cosine of theta over the sine of theta, and the cosecant of theta is the reciprocal of sine of theta. Now, I'm dividing by a fraction here, so that means I can multiply by its reciprocal. And I think we see what's going to happen. The sine of theta's cancel, just leaving me with cosine of theta as required. So that'll do it for part A. In part B, looking at this equation, which side is more complicated? Well, you could debate that, but certainly, if I start with this side, there's more things I can do. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And one of the things to do is to get a common denominator. So in this case, the common denominator, we need a factor of cosecant theta plus 1 and a factor of cosecant theta minus 1. We recognize these are going to give us their Pythagorean conjugates. So when we multiply that out, good things will happen. All right, so for the first fraction, let me just finish here. We're getting these common denominators. For the first fraction, we have a factor of cosecant theta plus 1. We're missing the factor cosecant theta minus 1. So whatever I multiply the bottom by, I got to multiply the top by. So there's that. Plus 1 times. And in this fraction, I'm missing a factor of cosecant theta plus 1. So I got to multiply top and bottom here by cosecant theta plus 1. All right, so I have the same denominator. I can just add the numerators. So I get cosecant theta minus 1 plus cosecant theta plus 1. That gives me 2 cosecant theta. And now we see what we get on the bottom. When I multiply this out, it's the difference of squares. I get cosecant squared theta minus 1. This should ring a bell. I know from identities that 1 plus cotangent squared theta is cosecant squared theta. That's one of the Pythagorean identities. If I rearrange this, subtract 1 off both sides, cosecant squared theta minus cotangent squared theta is 1. Excuse me. I want cosecant squared minus 1. Cosecant squared minus 1 is cotangent squared theta. So that means I have 2 cosecant theta over cotangent squared theta. Now, looking at what I want, so somehow this has to get down to 2 secant theta tangent theta. Now cotangent squared is 1 over tangent squared. Cosecant is 1 over sine. So it looks like what I want to do is get things back to sine and cosine and see what falls out. So the 2 is fine because I want a 2 at the end. Cosecant theta is 1 over sine theta. And cotangent squared theta would be cosine squared theta over sine squared theta. So if I invert and multiply, I get 2 times 1 over sine theta times sine squared theta over cosine squared theta. I do get some cancellation. The sine thetas cancel out. And now I'm left with 2 sine theta over cosine squared theta. Alright, so I get 2 times sine theta over cosine squared theta. So how can I get to secant theta tangent theta? Well, I can rewrite this as 1 over cosine theta times sine theta over cosine theta. The sine over the cosine is what's giving me the tangent, and the 1 over the cosine is what's giving me the secant. So after all that work, we get down to what we want. So getting common denominators, recognizing Pythagorean conjugates, and then once again, dealing with complex fractions are some of the tricks of the trade to verify identities. That does it for part B. All right, in 5C, once again, you could argue which is the more complicated expression. We're going to start with the left-hand side here. Because once again, one of these standard techniques is to look for Pythagorean conjugates. And secant theta minus 1 is a Pythagorean conjugate. We have the identity, the Pythagorean identity, 1 plus tangent squared theta is secant squared theta. That means that tangent squared theta is secant squared theta minus 1. And once again, I can think of this as the difference of two squares, secant squared theta minus 1 squared. So secant theta minus 1, secant theta plus 1. So I'm going to multiply the numerator and denominator by the Pythagorean conjugate. All right, so I'm not going to multiply out the numerator because I know what the denominator is going to end up being. When I multiply out the denominator, I get secant squared theta minus 1, which I know is tangent squared theta. So I cancel that, and now I'm down to secant theta plus 1 over tangent theta. Now, keeping the eyes on the prize here, I want cosecant theta plus cotangent theta. The cotangent theta I could get right here from the 1 over tangent theta. So I'll go ahead and separate the numerator. And this second term is going to give me directly what I want, the cotangent of theta. So hopefully I can get this to simplify to cosecant of theta. How am I going to do that? Well, at this point, I'm going to just convert back to sines and cosines because the secant of theta is 1 over the cosine of theta, whereas the tangent of theta is sine of theta over cosine of theta. Okay, so we're on the final stretch here. Once again, the way you divide fractions is you multiply by the reciprocal of the denominator, in this case cosine theta over sine theta. And I'm going to keep the cotangent theta because that's in my final answer. I want to keep that. And as we've seen, these folks cancel out. I'm left with 1 over the sine of theta plus the cotangent of theta, and that's cosecant theta plus cotangent theta, which is exactly what I needed to show. So that'll do it for part C, and that'll do it for number 5.